What is Voyager 1's ominous message warning us about? The Voyager 1 spacecraft, launched by NASA in 1977, entered interstellar space in 2012 and has since continued on its merry way. It eventually passed a distance of 14.5 billion miles, which is about 23.3 billion kilometers, from Earth. And while Voyager 1 is still functional, mission experts have discovered that it appears to be disoriented as to where in space it actually is. So, where exactly is the spacecraft? Did anything happen to it? Is it safe? And most importantly, what is Voyager 1's ominous mission warning us about? Keep watching this video to find out. Voyager 1 and its twin, Voyager 2, were managed by Suzanne Dodd of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in California. And according to the Voyager project manager, Alan Stern, a mystery like this is sort of par for the course at this stage of the Voyager mission. When asked about the age of the spacecraft, Dodd said, "The spacecraft are both almost 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. Moreover, we're also in interstellar space, a high radiation environment that no spacecraft has flown in before. The problem lies in the spacecraft's AACS, which is short for Attitude, Articulation, and Control System, which maintains the correct orientation of Voyager 1 and its antenna. The spacecraft is responding normally to orders, as expected, and delivering science data back to Earth with a full complement of power from the AACS. But the AACS is transmitting useless telemetry data to the spacecraft operators. When this problem first occurred, or how long it has persisted, is not clear from NASA's statement. The agency says that Voyager crew members will keep digging into the problem and trying to find a solution or work around it. Unfortunately, this is a slow procedure due to the fact that it now takes a signal from Earth 20 hours and 33 minutes to reach Voyager 1, and the same amount of time to receive the spacecraft's response. NASA has reported no issues with the Voyager 2 spacecraft, its twin that was launched in 1977. Due to the twin spacecraft's dwindling power supply, the mission team has disabled certain subsystems in an effort to prolong the probe's operational lifetime beyond 2025. Dodd remarked, "There are some big challenges for the engineering team, but I think if there's a way to solve this issue with the telemetry, our team will find it." 40-year-old lessons from Voyager 1's visit to Jupiter. 40 years ago, on August 15, 1977, Voyager 1 passed by Jupiter, unveiling an unexpected planetary system with icy and fiery moons. Even now, researchers are scouring the surfaces of some of these moons for telltale evidence of microbial life. In 1977, NASA's Voyager 1 and its identical twin, Voyager 2, blasted off from Earth to investigate a peculiar planetary alignment that occurs once every 175 years. A spaceship might exploit the gravitational pull of one gas giant planet to swing onto the next due to the alignment of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. While Voyager 1 visited Jupiter and Saturn, Voyager 2 flew past all four planets. Voyager 1 instead ascended high above the solar system's plane. The two probes measured the atmospheres, ring systems, magnetic fields, including Jupiter's exceptionally powerful one, and the possible inner core functions of these massive planets. Even though Pioneer had previously explored Jupiter, the planet still had surprises in store for Voyager 1 when it passed by in 1979. A picture of Jupiter and its moon Ganymede was taken by Voyager 1 in 1979. About a month before it came closest to the planet. It was discovered that Jupiter's atmosphere is more dynamic than it was during the Pioneer 10 and 11 flybys. This prompted scientists to reevaluate their previous models of Jupiter's atmosphere because they could not account for the observed changes. NASA officials said in a statement that the spacecraft imaged the moons Amalthea, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, showing details of their terrain for the first time. The heat generated by the stretching and relaxing of the moon suffers every 42 hours as its eccentric orbit gets it closer to and then farther from Jupiter's powers, Io's extraordinarily active volcanoes, NASA officials said. The spacecraft found two additional moons, Thebe and Metis, and a thin ring around the planet, making it the second planet known to have a ring at the time. NASA's Juno probe has begun routinely photographing Io's volcanic plumes. A closer look at Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto is on the horizon, thanks to Voyager's discoveries. Joint observations from the Voyager spacecraft, the Galileo mission, which orbited Jupiter between 1995 and 2002, and even the Hubble Space Telescope, which saw periodic spurts of what looks to be water emanating from Europa. All point to an icy surface and a potential global ocean beneath. It is plausible that the oceans on these moons have all the components necessary for life because of the severe stretching the interiors undergo as they round Jupiter. However, more spacecraft observations are required to prove this. NASA is working hard on the Europa Clipper, which will orbit Europa in the 2030s to determine if the ice moon has environments favorable to the survival of microorganisms. In 2022, the European Space Agency launched the Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, also known as JUICE, mission from Earth to investigate all three icy moons, but with a focus on Ganymede. JUICE is investigating the oceans, ice layers, general geology, tenuous atmospheres, exospheres, as well as the moon's magnetic fields. Five facts about NASA's far-flung Voyager spacecraft. In the late 1970s, NASA sent a pair of Voyager spacecrafts to the solar system's outer planets. After nearly 40 years, two spacecrafts are finally leaving our local galaxy and making their journey to the threshold of interstellar space. Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California, which is part of NASA, created the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 spacecraft and maintains control of both. To celebrate the longest continually operational spacecraft in deep space, here are five interesting tidbits about the two Voyager probes. 1. They are specifically built to travel long distances. Spacecraft Voyager 1 was launched on September 5, 1977, and Voyager 2 was launched roughly 2 weeks later on August 20, 1977. Since then, each spacecraft has taken a unique route, moving across space at a variable rate of speed. Currently, the farthest human-made object from Earth, Voyager 1, is around 10.8 billion miles from the Sun and speeding toward interstellar space. About 8.8 billion miles separate Voyager 2 from the Sun. 2. It has proven difficult to get in touch with them. For now, getting in touch with the Voyager spacecrafts has proven to be harder than initially imagined. However, probes continue to communicate with NASA's Deep Space Network, relaying scientific data about their environments. It has taken roughly 18 hours for a signal sent from Earth and traveling at the speed of light to reach Voyager 2, and around 20 hours to reach Voyager 1. 3. The Voyager embarked on a spectacular tour of the solar system. The Voyager's primary 5-year mission was to investigate Jupiter and Saturn up close, as well as the rings of Saturn and its larger moons. However, a string of successes led to a mission extension. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are the four largest planets in our solar system, and the two spacecraft have collectively mapped out their ring and magnetic field systems, as well as probed their 49 moons. The Voyager interstellar mission is now underway with the intention of exploring the outskirts of our solar system and breaking out into interstellar space, which is the region of space between the stars. 4. The Voyager is sending signals to extraterrestrials. The recorded Earth messages are housed on gold phonograph records, which are 12-inch gold-plated copper disks, and are on board both Voyager spacecraft. NASA's record-keeping was overseen by a panel that the late Carl Sagan, an astrophysicist, led. The albums serve as cultural time capsules that the Voyagers will transport to distant solar systems. Images and field recordings of wildlife, greetings spoken in 55 languages, and musical selections from various cultures and times are all included. 5. The Voyagers are forging ahead. Voyager 1 has arrived at the solar system's rim, where the solar wind's outward momentum has ceased. This is yet another significant event in Voyager 1's journey through the heliosheath and forward into interstellar space. Leaving the heliosphere behind, Voyager 1 is expected to enter interstellar space over the next 5 years. That being said, we have to wait to find out when the Voyager mission will return to Earth. That's if it ever returns. For now, NASA officials will keep communicating with the pair of spacecrafts with hopes of making new discoveries as the years go by. Who knows? Voyager 1 might even make some significant communication with extraterrestrials and reveal new, faraway worlds to the people of Earth. Thanks for watching.